My name is Guido Varnet, and I am the mayor of the small town called Bonheuren, which lies in Belgium, about 20 kilometers outside of Brussels. I want to talk to you about how sustainable policies can make us happier, or how a policy of happiness can be sustainable. It has been shown that 40% of our happiness is decided by our environment factors. This means that policymakers have a big influence on the happiness of citizens. That is why all council members of Bonheuren, including myself, were given an extra competence on the 1st of January this year, the competence of happiness. I've been a mayor for 4 years now and will continue to be so for the next 2 years. Through the ups and downs of my legislature, I have learned the importance of the 7 commandments of happiness. The first commandment, change your attitude. Nobody likes change, but change is necessary if we want to have progress. By encouraging the power of imagination in your colleagues, politicians, your co-workers, and also in your citizens, you will come up with creative solutions to today's problems. The second commandment for me is more yes, but, and less no, because. Make more room for positivism and less room for negativism. Convince your co-workers to use their energy to find arguments why something is possible or okay, instead of using it to list reasons why something is not possible or not okay. The third commandment is supportive leadership for more creativity. Invite your co-workers to pitch their creative ideas. Evaluate their potential without being distracted by possible obstacles. Let them make mistakes, because who doesn't? The fourth commandment is positive citizens' participation. Have your citizens participate actively in the political process. Inform your citizens about the overall aim of a certain policy choice. The fifth commandment is the context of happiness. Action groups originate from frustration about decisions when not enough information is provided or when the decisions haven't been situated in their global context. Taking the time to put everything into the right context will make your citizens feel connected to the decision. For example, our town council wants to create 8 roads where bikes have the upper hand over cars. This was with big resistance from our citizens. After explaining the main aim of the decision, 99% of the concerned residents vote in favor of the bike roads and were even willing to promote the concept. By putting this in the context of happiness, people acknowledge the global impact and the process it creates without getting to catch up in their own personal situation. In Bonheuren, we use banners to engage our citizens in the flow of positivity. For example, we replace the sign reading, "Red, you were probably driving too fast," with the sign reading, "If less than 50 kilometers it's seen, you'll get green." The seventh commandment, create accessibility of governance. People really appreciate that politicians want to connect with their citizens outside of the electoral campaigns. In Bonheuren, I go to the market every Wednesday where people talk to me for different reasons. Sometimes for a little chat, sometimes to address a frustration they have had for years. I also started the round of Bonheuren with council members. Every week we visit between 30 and 50 families to give everyone a chance to share their thoughts. The possibility of citizens to vent make them happier. These were my 7 commandments of happiness. If you have any suggestions for the 8th, a 9th, a 10th or a 100th commandment, please let me know. Working towards happiness will never be a finished job. In Bonheuren, we're still learning too, and your suggestions will make us very happy. Thank you.